Dallas the other day, and we had rice and chicken mix left over. So I'm just having a little taco. Oh my gosh, I wish I could share food through the screen because these enchiladas were just... It was my first time making enchiladas ever. So I was really happy that they came out. Oh, I forgot cheese. I have to get a blue cheese. Also, I recently discovered this drink. This is the Frosty Blue Lemonade. I got this from Dollar Tree and it is so good. Like, it tastes like blue lemonade, but it's made with carbonated water, so it has like the fizz of pop. When my body is not in survival mode, I am such a foodie. Like, I just love food. I am back in my HGTV era and I've been watching Hometown, so I'm gonna go ahead and throw that on and eat my dinner. It's been my vision board for quarter two of the year. Quarter two really started in May, but May wasn't a good month. So we're getting ourselves back together this month. So I went and made my vision board. I got all my pictures from Pinterest. I'm gonna show you guys a better view. But I'm actually gonna set this one as this phone's lock screen and not this one, because I want this one to be my summer mood board, which I'm not gonna make in this video. I'm gonna make in a different video. But I think that'll be really cute. So without going too much into my goals, I just have a few pages here for how I want like this next quarter to go. It's very hobby based, if I'm being honest, because I've really been telling myself I need to get back into my hobbies. And I use PhotoGrid. It's free. And it's for Apple and Android devices. So if you're interested, that's what I use. I know a lot of people use Canva, but for me personally, I don't like Canva when it comes to making grids, but I do like them for fonts. So like, I'll make my grids on here, even for my thumbnail, I'll make my grids on here, but then I'll use Canva for fonts. We have roast cooking in the oven. I started it yesterday. Yesterday I had like, we got home like 5 something and I immediately, like, my brain was immediately just like in, I don't want to say work mode because it wasn't really work, but when I tell you I was just so focused, I put on some music, I blasted it on the speaker, I prepped the roast to put them in the oven, and then I made cookie dough. And then, no, I did the roast, I did the dishes, and then I made cookie dough, and I didn't just do half the dishes like I usually do. Y'all know I'm good for that. I did all the dishes. And then turn around and make cookie dough. I literally went to sleep right after I did all of that. It felt really good. And I haven't feel like I haven't had a concert and just like rocked out like that in a while. Like, it was so much fun. But that's all I got for now. I want to bake cookies. Well, yeah, I want to bake cookies after the roast is done, because I'm using like an aluminum pan, and if y'all cook, y'all know they're not the sturdiest, so I'm using the cookie sheet as like support, so I can't bake cookies right now, but we will. That's all I got for you guys. I don't know what I'm about to do. I think I'm gonna plan. I got too much to plan, but I am gonna plan something. I don't know, maybe I'll do some reading. I want to get back into reading The Body Keeps the Score. I also did the book I was reading the other day. I finished it. No, let's talk about it. So I've been in a reading slump probably since like April. So like the beginning or middle of April. I don't think I've read a book since then. I could be lying. Okay, I'm lying. I did read books, but like they weren't, it wasn't doing much. I was gonna film a video of forcing myself out of a reading slump, but when I tell you, like, the books were good, but the way I was set up, like, it was just so unmoving to me. And I'm like, wow, I'm gonna have to reread these books. I got 3 books from the library. You guys saw that. I read Evermore. And, like, it was a good book. I just wasn't in the right space to read it. And so I read that, and I was just kind of like, okay. And I started The Stolen Heir, but then I never finished it. And the books were due. I didn't even look at the 3rd book, so I'm gonna go back for those eventually. But
And of course, once I returned them, that's when like I got back into the swing of reading. But I know if I would have kept those books, the slump just would have continued and it would have been all bad. But anyways, the other day, I was reading Pretend You're Mine. And I don't know, one thing about Lucy, this is not Lucy's first time getting me out of a reading slump. But, oh my gosh, it's either I either go to Wattpad or I go to Lucy. Or I reread one of my favorite books and it's like, wow, this is why I love reading. And then it kind of like rekindles the flame. Sorry my voice keeps cutting out. I haven't really talked today. I've just been enough by myself. And the most talking I've done is to tell the dog no and stop. I have a puppy. You guys don't know that because I keep filming videos about it and ditching them. But I have a puppy. Yeah. Started Pretend You're Mine. Don't know how many times I've said that already. And oh my gosh, I laughed, I cried, I squealed. You guys seen it. I squealed like that book was so good. And it's a series. Will I read the full series? I don't know, probably not. I think I'm thinking of Blue Moon series is like 8 books, and I'm not gonna lie to you, I read the first one. Don't, like, the description sounds familiar, but if I read it this year, I didn't mark it, so I really don't know. So I'm gonna reread that after I finish this book here. But if I read the Blue Moon series, it'll probably be like the first 2 or 3 books, and then like the 7th book, because it's a prequel and I think it's about the parents. So, I'm sorry, I'm trying to get on my Kindle app. So, I don't know how to pronounce the city that they live in, so I'm gonna put it on the screen, the name of the series. There's 3 books, so I'll probably read the whole series because why not? The Blue Moon series is 8 books, I'm not doing that. Anyways, the book was really good. I'm on the second one. I feel like I keep repeating myself. I'm just glad to be back reading, glad to be back in books, glad to, you know, feel something when I read, because when I read those other books, it was just words. I wasn't taking nothing in. And it's nothing against the books, because I read Evermore in middle school or high school, and I loved the book. And that's why I saw it, I was like, oh my gosh, I have to get this, because I remember how much I loved it and I never finished the series, so I'm like, I might as well do it now. So like, I remember enough of the books that if I did want to still go through with the series, I still can. But I don't know, it was just kind of sad that I didn't appreciate it. And the same thing with The Stolen Heir. Like, I loved, 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 loved the Folk of the Air series. And if you guys have been watching me since last summer, you know I raved about it. But, and the book was, again, the book was good. I love Holly Black. I love her writing. She's very good at mystery and fantasy. Like, but anyways, I lost my train of thought. I'm gonna go. We'll talk later.
Thank you.
family dinner tonight. And this is the first event I'm hosting that I'm, well, no, it's not. I was gonna say the first event I'm cooking for, but I had a housewarming, but I didn't cook for that. But I did have a birthday party and I cooked for that, but it was like 4 people. But today, my siblings are coming over. My sister's here already, as you guys saw. And my brothers and my grandma and one of my brother's girlfriend is coming up. So, that'll be fun. I'm getting ready to start cooking. Dinner is 5:30. It's 4 o'clock. Should I have started this late? No, but I set an alarm. Well, I told Siri to set the alarm, but Siri didn't set it. I'm about to play some music, and we're going to get started. Okay. Why so serious? Is probably one of my most favorite things ever. It's just something about a cup of tea that just makes me feel really good. I don't know. Y'all know the characters in like literally everything who thinks tea solves every problem. I am one of those people. And it's literally so simple. And I can customize it the way I want. I can drink as many cups as I like. There's so many different flavors, and it's like, I know I can always turn to a cup of tea. And that kind of sounds silly, I feel like. But it's true. Me and tea are like this. This little portion is going to conclude this video. I 100% cannot see. I'll be right back. This video for me was really just to give myself a pause, I guess. I'm one of those people who are always go, go, go. And sometimes it's easy to get caught up in life, and so I think it's important to just take time for yourself to do things that make you feel good, that make you happy, that you enjoy. You guys didn't see a lot of what I did, but honestly the past week or however long that I've been filming this video has been a pretty good week, and I've enjoyed it. Just take time for yourself, make sure you're taking care of yourself, and make sure you're being kind to yourself and to others. This feels weird. I'll talk. Bye.